In the today's lecture we are going to see phasor representation of alternating quantity. So till now we have studied how to represent the alternating quantity or any electrical quantity with the help of waveform and mathematical expression. So another way of representing the alternating quantity is the phasor representation. Okay, so there are two types of graphical representation of alternating quantity. One is the waveform representation, and which is the most simpler way of representation, and another way of representing the quantity in a graphical way, which is the phasor representation of alternating quantity. So what is phasor? Phasor is a straight line with arrow indicated at one side. So you can see the phasor diagram. There are two diagrams in the slide. On left hand side there is a phasor diagram. Okay, so there are two axes drawn, x axis and y axis, and over which one circle is drawn. So that circle is continuous circle, okay, but assume that it is the dotted circle, okay, and one bold line, okay, there is one bold arrow line which is drawn in between x and y, we can say it as the x and y axis. Okay, and that line makes inclination angle of theta. Okay, that bold line is actually the phasor. Okay, and ahead of that phasor and or the on the top of that phasor there is the one arrow indicated, which indicates the direction of rotation of the phasor. Okay, so phasor is a straight line with arrow indicated at one side. So on the top of phasor there is one arrow indicated, and the length of phasor represents the magnitude of the sinusoidal quantity. So what is the length of that phasor? That length of phasor equal to the peak value of sinusoidal quantity. So one sinusoidal quantity is given in the diagram, okay, on the right hand side of the phasor diagram. Okay, so on the right hand side it is the waveform representation. Okay, and on left hand side it is the phasor representation, and the magnitude of that phasor represents the magnitude of sinusoidal quantity, and it always rotates in the anticlockwise direction. So in summary we can say that what is phasor? Simply, phasor is a straight line. Okay, you can see it is the straight line. Okay, and one arrow indicated at one side. Okay, one arrow indicated at top of the phasor, which indicates the direction of rotation, and that phasor rotates in anticlockwise direction. Okay, and the length of phasor equal to the peak value of sinusoidal quantity. What is the amplitude of sinusoidal quantity? Okay, that length is equal to the length of the phasor. Okay, so in short we can remember 2-3 points about the phasor. What is phasor? Phasor is a straight line, you can see in the diagram. The length of phasor equal to the peak value of sinusoidal quantity. Okay, and one arrow indicated at one side, which represents the direction of rotation of the phasor. Okay, so these are the most simplest explanation of phasor. Okay, so only remember 3 points about the phasor. First point is phasor is a straight line. Second point is length of phasor equal to the peak value of sinusoidal quantity. And third point is the arrow indicated at one side of phasor, which represents the direction of rotation of phasor and which is the anticlockwise direction. Okay, next one is the phase angle. It is the angle made by conductor with reference axis in the generator. So you can see most simplest form of generator, and there is one reference axis, okay, which is drawn in between two poles, north pole and south pole. Okay, so there are two permanent magnets, north pole and south pole. North pole emits the magnetic flux and that goes terminates with south pole. Okay, and in between that magnetic flux there is a presence of single turn coil. Okay, and it is the most simplest form of generator. Okay, when that coil starts rotating, it actually cuts the magnetic flux, and according to Faraday's law, if any conductor cut varying magnetic field, EMF induced into that conductor. Okay, so that coil is not a stationary coil, that coil is the rotational coil, and whatever angle that whatever angle made by that coil with reference to reference axis or with respect to reference axis is called as the phase angle. Okay, so angle made by that conductor or angle made by that coil with respect to the reference axis is called as the phase angle, and induced EMF is, or instantaneous voltage induced into that coil is V is equal to Vm sine of theta. So that instantaneous voltage is totally depend on the phase angle, or phase angle is nothing but the theta. So theta is called as the phase angle, angle made by that conductor with respect to the reference axis. And on depend on value of that theta, the value of instantaneous voltage we get. Okay, this is called as the phase angle. So in short, what is phase angle? Angle made by conductor with respect to the reference axis is called as the phase angle. And instantaneous voltage depends on the phase angle theta, Vm sine of theta, and theta is called as the phase angle. Next one is the phase difference. It is the difference between phases of two alternating quantity in a radian or a degree. So if you take difference between two phases, it gives us the phase difference, and that difference is can be measured in a radian or a degree. So we can see there are two sinusoidal quantities which shown in the waveform, red sinusoidal quantity and blue sinusoidal quantity, and there is a difference between two phases. Okay, so there are two phases, red phase and blue phase. So there is a difference between these two phases, and that difference is the theta angle, and that theta can be measured in degree or the radian. Okay, so both the sinusoidal quantity does not starts from the origin. Okay, so their starting points are different in time. Okay, so we can measure their differences in phases with respect to their starting points. Okay, and that difference is the phase difference, and measured in degree or a radian. So V is equal to Vm sine of omega t. Suppose that red phase is the voltage phase. We can assume that red phase is the voltage phase. So what is the instantaneous equation? V is equal to Vm sine of omega t. And suppose that blue phase is the current phase. So what is the instantaneous voltage for current? I is equal to Im sine of omega t minus theta, because that current lags voltage by angle of theta degree. Okay, so ahead is current, ahead is voltage, and behind is current. So current is lagging to the voltage by theta degree. So I is equal to Im sine of omega t minus of theta. If you plot the phasor diagram for both the phases, phase 1 is the voltage phase and phase 2 is the current phase. So if you want to draw phasor diagram for two different sinusoidal quantities, so what is the procedure to draw the phasor? First step is to draw the horizontal or reference axis. So we have drawn the reference axis, which is the horizontal axis. So if there are more than phasors we have to draw, then any one phasor we can draw on the reference axis. So we have drawn the phasor for current on the reference axis. Okay, so you can see in the diagram, on the reference axis there is a current phasor I. And what is the length of that phasor? Length of that phasor equal to the peak value of sinusoidal quantity for the current. So what is the magnitude of that current quantity? That magnitude is equal to the length of phasor. Okay, so next phasor we can draw, which is the voltage phasor. So with the help of mathematical equation, we can see that the voltage is ahead of current by theta degree. Okay, the voltage is ahead of current by theta degree, or voltage leads current by theta degree. So we can take angle of theta. Okay, and we can take angle of theta, and we can draw the voltage phasor. Okay, so by taking leading angle of theta with respect to the phasor of current, we can draw the phasor for the voltage, which is drawn in the blue line. Okay, and what is the length for voltage phasor? It is equal to the peak value of voltage waveform, or peak value of sinusoidal quantity of voltage. So we have drawn the phasors for current and voltage simultaneously. Okay, so what is the procedure? First is to draw the reference axis. Next is to draw any one phasor on the horizontal axis. We have drawn the current phasor, and length of that phasor equal to the peak value of current waveform. Then next one is to draw the voltage waveform, and voltage waveform is ahead of current waveform by theta degree. So we have taken the theta degree angle between the reference axis and that phasor, or between the current phasor and that voltage phasor, and we have drawn the voltage phasor ahead of theta degree with respect to the current phasor. So that is the this is the phasor diagram for the voltage and current. Next one is the what is the importance of phasor representation? To represent the quantity with waveform is very for few quantities only, but for the large number of quantities it's very difficult process. But phasor representation is very easy way of representation. Okay, so basically waveform representation is one of the most simplest way of representing the alternating quantity, but it is only feasible or it is very easy process if only there is a few number of alternating quantities. Suppose there is only one alternating quantity we can draw, we can represent with the waveform, or we can represent the waveforms for three different alternating quantities, and that is RYB phase or a phase 1, phase 2 or phase 3, or if suppose it is the three phase waveform we can draw it. But if it is a more than three phases, or if it is a six phase waveform, it is very difficult to draw the six phase waveform. Okay, so to avoid that we can use the phasor representation. So phasor representation is the most simplest way of representing the alternating quantity if it is the multiphase waveform. Suppose even though there are the more than 10 phases, we can draw them with the help of phasor representation. So we can see in the diagram on the left hand side there is a waveform representation of three phase waveform. Okay, so to draw this three phase waveform we need at least 5 to 10 minutes. Okay, suppose you are new to draw it. Okay, and you need at least 5 to 10 minutes. But on the right hand side it is the phasor representation. So to draw that phasor representation you just need a 1 or 2 minutes. Okay, so to represent the waveforms or to represent the alternating quantity with the help of phasor is very simple way. Okay, so it needs a very less efforts. Okay, it needs a very less time. So what is the importance of phasor representation? Suppose there are more than three phases, or it is a multiphase waveform, or it is a multiphase quantities sinusoidal quantity waveform, then we cannot draw it its waveform, but we can draw the phasor representation. So phasor representation is most important in a multiphase waveform representations. Okay, so that is the importance of phasor. So with this we are going to stop here.